guys, it's Miles from Miles Stands Ministries. I just wanted to share my testimony on how I met Jesus. Growing up poor, my mom and dad raised me in a poor family. We were born in poverty. Being born the eldest and only son, my parents had high expectations of me to rise from poverty. Money was tight and fights were common in my family. I would often hear my mom and dad fight about money over and over again. It was like my parents were OFWs because they were never at home. They were always absent and they worked hard to make ends meet. We were so poor that we never had air conditioning when I grew up. My parents, sisters, and I all slept in the same room with a single electric fan. Even though they worked hard, they never bought what I wanted because we were so poor. Whenever I wanted to buy a toy, my mom would always say no. I always prayed for the newest toys but never got them. I learned early on to rely on myself for success and not in God. Eventually, when my mom would go shopping for my three sisters, they would always get what they wanted. They always had new things. My mom said that when I buy new things for your sisters, I can always hand them down and it would be cost effective. Compared to the other kids, I never got the love and joy that a child should get growing up. This made me feel unloved and neglected as a child. To drown my sorrows, I remember playing video games at a very young age. My uncles would always invite me for play dates, and I would always sleep over my cousin's house every week just so that I can play on his Super Nintendo, on their family computers, and their Game Boys. Our regular weekends would involve my dad going to the hardware store, my mom going to the grocery store, and I would be going to the video game arcade of that mall. I would burn through my tokens just to have a little fun in my life. In my mind, I was happy. My parents didn't have to worry about me because I was staying at home, staying at other people's homes, and not getting into trouble. I was spending my savings because I didn't want to be a financial burden to my parents while they were still struggling in business. I would wake up 6 a.m. and play video games until lunchtime, take a small break to have lunch, and resume my playing time from 1 p.m. to 12 midnight straight. That was my childhood. The pinnacle of my teenage years were filled with PC desktop games, PlayStations, and I preferred to shut myself in my room and have fun for hours and hours galore. I also discovered pornography and became addicted to masturbation. As long as I manipulated multiple women for fun and got what I wanted, I would be totally okay. I saw people as objects and used people and the love of things instead of loving people and using things. As I grew older, I became even more envious of my classmates in my school. I often questioned why everything was given to them by their fathers and I had to suffer being poor. In Tagalog, parati mababa score ko sa Filipino. I would always get high grades in math, English, and science, and low grades in Tagalog because my parents never had time to teach me Tagalog. I would always fail in Tagalog. And in Katagalogin ko, kapag sumagot ka, bastos ka, disrespectful. Hindi ako naman ako makasagot kasi kapag gumanti ako, magiging rebelde daw ako. While other people played in the summer, I worked in SM as a bagger boy. I would enjoy being a bagger boy in SM because you only stood there and packed goods for other people as you earned a minimum wage. This was my summer while other kids were playing games and enjoying basketball summer camps. I would spend my time trying to earn money to buy the things that I wanted. The worst times was when I would work at the fourth floor of this mall. This was SM Mega Mall, and because the toy section was there, I would see so many happy families buy new toys for their kids, but never for me. I was taught only to depend only on myself and my abilities to get what I want because my parents could never give what I want. These experiences made me an angry, bitter, and judgmental person since I was always being compared to other kids and I was always comparing myself with what other people had. Everything got worse in college. I met more friends who were just as passionate as me in video games. I looked forward to cutting classes. I didn't care if I got low grades as long as I had fun with my friends in my video games. I was introduced to multiplayer games like Dota, Ragnarok Online, and World of Warcraft, where you can interact with millions of players around the world. I even participated in local online tournaments farmed virtual gold online and started selling my video game services to my peers. In my mind, video games were a source of income. I told myself that I had to be more powerful in the video games so I could get more money and avoid bothering my parents for an increase in my allowance. I noticed that I felt a great sense of achievement killing difficult raid bosses with my friends. I also noticed that I got angry often if I lost a game or if I died to my enemies multiple times. Whenever I was online, it felt like paradise because I could be whoever I wanted to be in the virtual world. It was a welcome distraction that allowed me to escape from my problems in the real world because I was accomplishing so many achievements in the virtual world. I started getting into vices like smoking, heavy drinking, gambling, clubbing until 6 a.m., doing drugs, and dating many girls at the same time. I spent all my money and didn't have savings. The pride in my heart increased even more because I was succeeding in life by my worldly standards. After I earned my first million pesos, I started to rebel even more against my parents. I broke down the Great Wall by getting a Filipina girlfriend, and I knew this would hurt my parents, but I didn't care. I had money, I had freedom, I could date whoever I want, and I thought I was godlike. In Tagalog, mukha lang mayaman pero nagpapanggap lang. Puro dating, walang datong. When trials would come, I would always ask God to fix my problems. But when it was solved, I would always go back to my old ways. I was unforgiving, jealous, and rebellious because I had an empty hole in my heart that I thought material things and fun could fill. I was trapped in the cycle of trauma, abuse, neglect, narcissism, and rejection, and I thought it was okay. As long as I made my own money, everything would be okay. In Tagalog, pera-pera lang naman. Importante sa magulang ko, pera. So I was trying to fill the hole in my heart with money and women and whatever the world had to offer. Little did I know that hurt people hurt people. Viktor Frankl, a Nazi concentration camp survivor who wrote the best-selling book Man's Search for Meaning, once said, "Most people never find their purpose in life and spend most of their time chasing shallow pursuits." This was me. Eventually, I met a Christian girl who I made my girlfriend. She was secretly praying for me and invited me to a CCF retreat in 2011. It was there where I learned about the wages of sin, their death, and how Jesus paid the price for my sins on the cross, laying down his life for me. I found out someone loves me and is willing to forgive all of my sins no matter how shameful and evil I was. I gave my life to Jesus and accepted him as my Lord and Savior on November 11, 2011. Or 11-11-11. 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, "Kaya kung nagkipag-isa na kay Christ ang isang tao, bagong creation na siya. Wala na yung luma, bago na ang lahat. The old is gone, the new has come." In 2012, I broke up with my girlfriend and gave up all my vices. Slowly, I started stopping all of my vices one by one and started obeying my parents more. I started reading the Bible every day, prayed to God every morning, and I even joined a D group in CCF. Slowly, Jesus began to fill the empty void in my heart. In 2013, I closed down my personal businesses and joined the family business, as if I was led by the Holy Spirit to help my parents. So in Tagalog, tumutulong na rin po ako sa negosyo ng pamilya namin para makaretire na ang mga magulang ko. I forgave my parents and I told them that I love them. First time ko po sinabi sa tatay ko na I love you. The anger, jealousy, and unforgiveness that I had towards my parents slowly went away because I knew Christ forgave me. Slowly, I experienced the love, joy, and kindness that the Bible talked about. In 2014, I became an active member in CCF, and I also became an active member in various civic organizations such as JCI. I, along with my newfound Christian friends, helped co-organize CCF events like the pursuit of happiness, because I wanted to share what I had found. I wanted to share the gospel with my family and friends. The pursuit of happiness event was graced by the Honorable Pastor Peter Tanchi, the Honorable Dr. Cecilio Pedro, and honorable pastors such as Pastor Manny and Lisa Manansala and Edric and Joy Mendoza. In 2015, I was led by the Holy Spirit to start my own D group. With two guys in the beginning, we just met a couple of times, and by obeying the Lord and doing His will, we slowly grew in our walk with Christ. By God's grace, my D group eventually grew to a discipleship of 7 men. In 2016, I took on the challenge to become one of the leaders in the Banawe Fellowship Group, or BFG for short. I became a Bible study leader in the Banawe area, leading 60 Filipino Chinese to grow more in their Christ-like faith. I also became more active in CCF's Philchai ministry called the Friends Ministry, helping out wherever I was needed. By the way, remember the low grades in Tagalog? By the grace of God, He has allowed me to preach in various Bible studies and ministries, and believe it or not, church it, in Tagalog and in Taglish, much to the delight of the youth today. You see, guys, transform people. The love of Jesus transformed me, and I just couldn't contain it. One CCF message convicted me when Peter Tanchi Jr. spoke at CCF about his video game addictions. He described how 30,000 hours of his life was wasted away and his potential was wasted if only he had quit earlier. The message hit home to me because I had lost so many business opportunities and personal growth opportunities. I wish I had quit earlier. I decided then and there to quit all forms of video games, and I sold all of my accounts and uninstalled all of the games that I had. I replaced video games by reading more business and leadership books, researching on the stock market, and watching GLC videos from CCF. In the virtual world, I was always leveling up, always getting richer, and always getting ahead. Even though it did not affect my personal life. I had virtual cash, but not real cash. Now that I am free, I remember that this is my second chance, my second life to serve the Lord. Just like the parable of the fig tree in Luke 13:6-9, I now look forward to serving Jesus, not just for 30,000 hours, but for all the days of my life. In closing, God uses broken people like you and me to help broken people like you and me. In John 15, it says, I am the vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, He takes away. And every branch that does bear fruit, He prunes, that it may bear more fruit. Already you are clean because of the word that I have spoken to you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit by itself unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, and you are the branches. Whoever abides in me and I in him, he it is that bears much fruit, for apart from me, you can do nothing. I am Miles Tan, once a mess, now a messenger of the Lord. I was once a sinner, now saved by grace. Please pray for me because I am still a work in progress. All the praises, honor, and glory goes to God.